It looks so nice. It makes you think it's open world, but we all know that's cardboard right there. So you know what? Let's go ahead and move on. Written in the stars, you, me, forever, yeah. What's up, boo? Welcome back to my channel. I hope you're having a great day. If you're new to my channel, welcome to the dark side. Because I am bringing you another mod list video. There's a stranger in my house. Why are you here? I am about to extreme lie and see you like real quick. Hold up, give me 1 minute. Yeah, exactly. Goodbye. Alright, so back to what we was doing. Don't tell me he's about to come in here. What's up, one of my cats? Okay, so I'm doing a mod list video for minor mods. It's been a minute since I did minor mods, and I know a lot of you have your games packed full of mods because of me. And if you don't because of me, then that's an issue. Okay. But let's go ahead and jump right in because I know there are a lot of minor mods that give you realistic gameplay. First one is the No Mosaics mod. For those of you who don't want Wicked Whims in your game per se, and I even took my Wicked Whims out of my game just to show you how it looks because I think about shit like that. It just takes the little mosaic when your Sims are peeing in the shower and they're doing all any other tasks that requires the mosaic. So as you can see, my Sim is like just sitting on the toilet. She has her skirt still on. I mean, it does look kind of weird. I wish we did have an animation where they pull the pants down because, you know, and see, well, no, just get in the shower. Just do that. And she's in the shower. No mosaic, but her underwears are still on. That's basically what it does. I mean, just no mosaic because sometimes the mosaic gets in the way. I don't know if for some of you who play with like a lot of bathrooms, I know on stream last night, twitch.tv/ItsmeTroi, it's free to follow and to watch if you enjoy live streams. We had a lot of issues with the mosaics, like in the background, like we had a lot of bathrooms and we were at the studio and it was just like you could see the mosaic through the door. I don't know why that was, but you know, that problem should be fixed now. The next mod I want to show you is from Turbo Driver, and Turbo Driver does have a mod the Sims page where they put up mods that don't relate to Wicked Whims, and they did a less intrusive conversations mod, stop strangers from interrupting you. So basically this mod does is a script that modifies Sim behavior of joining into ongoing conversations. Strangers should not be joining social groups without being explicitly invited, and this mod aims to make that a reality. I try to do this entire sentence in one breath. I don't know if you caught that, but I was struggling a little bit. It just makes it so, you know, you don't have awkward conversations. Like, Sims are not just joining you willy-nilly, and sadly it be like that in The Sims, or you need a mod to fix it. Hey boo, Troy here. Don't forget to get your exclusive membership badge and benefits from Mod Addicts Anonymous. That's linked in the description box below. Also, like this video, big thumbs up, and keep watching towards the end. Bye! Alright, so we're gonna continue on with Mod The Sims because this mod requires you have a toddler or a child or somewhat. I don't have those. I don't play with those in the game. I mean, I rarely do. For those of you who know me, fuck them kids. But anyway, this is the Don't Take My Child Away. This mod makes it so your child does not leave if they have an F in school. I did not know the game took your child away from them failing. When your child's grade school score dropped down to poor F, you'll get a notification due to neglect. Someone's being whisked away to safety. We need another chance. Just don't take away the child with none of any warning. So this mod is for this. With this mod, your child will never be taken away from you when her or his grade school score dropped down to poor F. So I have children, and if you knew that they get taken away with the F grade, and they did, and you're kind of pissed about it because I will be pissed too, go ahead and download this mod. Alright, so the next mod is by Zero, and universally change into everyday for class. Basically, what this mod does, it makes it so your Sims do not go to class in their pajamas. I don't know about you, but my Sims are going in pajamas, their stripper clothes, their club clothes. They were going into everything but what they needed to go into. So this mod makes it so they change into their everyday all the time, and then get the hell out and go to class. The next mod, and the next couple mods are by Zero as well. I'm gonna go ahead and throw that out there to you. But the next mod is the University Rejection, my take on it. So how does it work? Exactly as in default EA settings, you send the application and then you wait. You can get the result by checking the status on PC and phone, or wait for the rejection letter that will be delivered just like EA settings. You do need another mod for this. You need the updated XML injector. You'll actually need to go to the updated website that they put Scumbubble's mods on. But if you want your Sims to have a more, like a double the chance of getting rejected, because I know my Sims did when we took her. Well, we didn't take her. We tried to get her to university. She had no skills, no nothing. And of course, she got rejected. Like, why would they accept her? Like, that made no sense. Okay, so yeah, this is what that mod does. The next mod is university teens jump to university. So in my mod, the school will be the one to offer a high school A student the chance to enroll in university during school hours. The chances are not so high, but they're way higher. If your teen sim is a genius, they may be asked to go ahead and just jump to university as a teen. All right, for those of you who live in the United States, mainly I do, for those of you who went through the university school system, I did, then you know university cost in the United States is not free and it's very painful. So this mod makes it so university costs more. I did this mod back when university first came out. I did a sleuth of, is sleuth the right word? I don't really know. I did a lot of university related mods back then. You can check them out on my channel. But this mod was like chef's kiss. It basically made it so university is fucking high. Like really high. And if you guys want universities, you know, to be high, for those of you who, you know, then I highly suggest you go and download this mod. All right, so we're back in game. I know we spent so much time on the game. I apologize. I try to like mix it up so that way I'm not just continuously on pages. But the next mod is from Scarlet, and it's the Always Buy Unlocked. Okay, so with this mod, according to Scarlet, with this mod, BB.ignore gameplay unlock settlement, which ignores requirements and unlocks objects in build buy mode, will always be activated. So I'm guessing any item that you needed to, I want to say, unlock something for. So I don't know which, I don't know. I don't really play with any of the locked objects, just because I rarely get my Sims to the levels they need to do, need to be at in order for it to be unlocked. But I'm guessing like they're unlocked now because I see no unlockables at all. Do I have a filter? Styles, content, okay, here we go. Unlocks. Okay, here we go. So yeah, it looks like all of these are unlocked now. If you don't want to, you know, see, it says unlocked at level 4 of the painter career. So if you don't want to go through all that, just download this mod from Scarlet and it unlocks all the unlockables for you without having to put the cheat in, which is amazing. Thank you so much. So the next mod is also by Scarlet, and it allows the island notifications to like pop up. So those of you who have island living, then you know you don't really get a notification when they're like the potluck or any other island activity for island living. So the island celebration event is starting. The Sulani Island celebration event has started. Travel to Ohanalii town to join the festivities. And that's basically all this mod does. It just tells you in the notifications that something is starting on or in Sulani, and you can go if you want to. That's all this mod does. All right, so another mod by Scarlet, I like to, you know, group everything together, is the No Blur and Distance. And I'm guessing, since I see no blur, that it just takes the blur away. That's all it does. So this mod was originally by Shinron, and I believe Scarlet took it over. So you can go ahead and download this, but there's no blur. We can see everything clearly. I believe this works, so that's pretty cool. I really wish we had like a really detailed open world. It looks so nice. It makes you think it's open world, but we all know that's cardboard right there. So you know what, let's go ahead and move on. All right, for the sake of this video, I got some children in the house. So I got a teen and I have a child sim, just to show you this next mod, which is the subject homework. So for children, this adds the following options. It basically adds subjects, like school subject, to their homework. So as you can see, I'm on the teen sim. She has the blue book. And we can do art analysis essay, which includes painting, practice creative writing with creatures writing, research astronomy, which is with rocket science, solve algebraic expressions, logic, study music theory, which is guitar, study sociology, which is charisma, write fitness articles, which is for fitness. And I believe you can do multiple of these, if I'm not mistaken. It's also for the child sims. Do math problems, fill out activity chart, practice vocabulary, and review social studies, which, you know, adds mental, motor, creative, and social for them. And you can see she has a little thing up there. She would actually be at her desk, prefer desk mod, but I don't have a desk for her, so you know it'd be like that sometimes. All these weird sims are coming to my house because of the new life drama mod. Oh my god. All right, so the last couple of mods I want to show you are homework tweaks, also by Scarlet. This is his faster homework and preferred desk, so you can choose your flavor, 10, 25, or 50 minutes for your Sims to do their homework, and they will prefer their homework at a desk if you can see it, if they can find one. As you can see, I didn't have an available desk, so my teen Sim did not do her homework at once. She did it on the bed, so bam. And then last is the children toddlers can die of anything. It's kind of morbid, that's why I left it at the end, but this mod enables the ability for toddlers and children to die of anything that teens and adults can. No dying of old age for obvious reasons. So yeah. Alright boo, so that is the end of this video. I hope you enjoyed it. I'm gonna yell at this person because why are you coming into my house like this? Don't forget to like and subscribe to your girl's channel for more mods. I'll have another mod list this weekend and I will see you guys next time. Bye, boo.